This is part two of the video of making hands. We're going to add color at this moment. Welcome to the Ayala Art I Love to Paint channel. This is your artsy friend Martha. If you are art inclined, love painting, drawing, art journaling, and mixed media, this is your channel. I am thinking, since I love pink, I'm going to be using this color. But also, I was thinking of some orange, because the skin tones are going to be looking nice against a very strong, solid background. So, one of the things that I like to do is take a scan or a picture of my art once it is finished, just in the pencil or the sketch or outline, and then print it. I'm going to do that. I already took the picture, but I'm going to be checking on the printed image some colors, because in the beginning I was thinking of adding a very light grayish blue, or maybe some aqua, some turquoise, because it goes well with the skin tones that I'm going to be using, which is some flesh tone and this bricky color that I like using for skin, and that goes well with my hands that are kind of in the olive bricky color. And I will be adding some neo color for the shadow areas, the little corners in the palm, or where the shadows go, and it is light blue. And I was thinking of maybe this salmon color for the fingernail, but I might use a little bit of white. This is, like I always explain when I remember, this is my basic beginning of a video. If I start adding colors, don't get too surprised, because sometimes I add up a lot and I don't use the things that I'm introducing in the beginning. I just like to grab spontaneously some other extra colors. But everything that I'm going to be using is in the information box below. I have a little link with Amazon shopping. If you want to do some shopping, it will help my channel and it will not be any extra cost to you. And I won't even know what you buy. So if you want to go and buy a refrigerator, that's fine too. Anyway, so I found also this little washi tape, and I think it's the cutest thing. So that's what kind of sort of stopped me from using the blues, because I have this like greenish and turquoise and then kind of yellow green, and it says make today amazing. And I'm going to put it somewhere around here because there's the space. So like I said, I am thinking I'm going in this direction. Let's see what happens. I didn't put any medium in my pencil, so it might move, but I don't care, because once the acrylic sits on top of the pencil, it's going to be fine. And I also wanted it to give me the basis of my shadow work over here, because the pencil will keep moving, so it gives you a little great area, and I like that. If you don't like it, then add medium spray or just a regular liquid or fluid matte medium, or if you like satin, go ahead. I just happen to like matte much better. For this brick color, which actually is called red oxide, is my super favorite color. I just opened a new jar. I don't know what happened to my other one that I had going. But anyway, just to show you that this is already too much for mixing with your skin tones. A drop goes a long way, especially if it splashes on you. But anyway, that's as little or as much as I'm going to be needing. Well, I tape my palette to the table because I don't want stuff flying around, but I'm basically just putting the little drip that you saw of the oxide into the other pink, and I'm working with a lot of water, which this paper can take, and also because I will be layering more stuff. So I just want it in layers, and I want it still very translucent. It's not the best way to treat acrylics, but we are in our sketchbook and we're making just a small page. If you were to be making a large canvas, if you wanted more like a glaze, transparent like this, add medium, not water, because you will have a mess when it dries. It will be flaky. The correct, more professional way of mixing the acrylics is about 30% of water, the most. And most people don't even like to put that. They just like to go with medium, which will allow you to make glazes or transparent layers and still acquire what you want with acrylics without having it flaky at the end. But like I said, since this is paper and it absorbs a lot, there's not going to be any flakes. And this book, in case that you want to know what it is a mixed media from Strathmore. I love these papers. It's very thick. It's not watercolor, but it can let you play with acrylics in watercolor and water-soluble crayons as well. Okay, let's add a little bit of this. If it is too dark, which I'm thinking it is, you can play with the color and remove as much as you want. But I wanted it more like white-ish, so it's a different value than the rest of the skin. So I'm going to add this creamy white, and I just erased my line. I'm going to add a little bit more of the line in there because I really wanted it. And I'm going to add some, where's my photo? A little bit of highlights in certain areas. You don't need much. This photo was pretty simple. Okay, so we have that. And if you have any questions, just pop a comment below the video. I'd love to hear from you. I'll answer your questions either in the group, which, by the way, if you're new here, consider subscribing, and consider also join my Facebook group called I Love to Paint. I have a link in the information box below. It only has two little questions and you're in. And I have a bunch of paint in my finger. Anyway, any questions that you might have, you can drop them here under the video or in the group. I want to add a little bit of pencil over here because I want to make the nail back to the size I had it before. All right. At this point, I will be adding my yellow, which I forgot to introduce you. Hello, this is yellow. It is a pollen color from Martha Stewart and I love it. It's super, super dense, opaque and bright. The color is bright, the value is bright, but the finishing is matte. It's not translucent. That's a problem with many of the yellows that are so light that they end up being translucent. And frankly, I just love my yellows very strong and not translucent. Now I'm going to bring a little bit yellow with the other color for here, for the wood part, which is still too yellow. I'm going to stretch this as a shadow. I also wanted to mention, whenever you have to paint a straight line, move your whole arm instead of just the finger. And also, it is perfectly valid if you want to put a piece of tape or a ruler and paint from there and then remove the tape or remove the ruler. Now I think I want to have an orange eraser. So I'm going to use this. Actually, no, I don't want orange. Hold on a second. I want red. Or that kind of pinkish. No, but the pink is going to get kind of gone if I have the rest of the pink in here. Well, okay. I'm going to add. I have this very bright red. Yeah, let's do that. I can always cover it with some other color if I don't like it, right? I'm going to wait for this to dry, and then I'm going to be adding the background color. I think I changed my mind one more time. And the pink is still too close. I love it, but it's going to be not enough contrast for my taste. So I'm going to skip it, and I'm going to go back to my original idea of this blue, which happens to be sky blue from Folk Art. It is a very pale and cool blue. And I had been thinking about it quite a bit because I wanted kind of a bit of a drama. I have this other, which is a very intense metallic periwinkle. It would look nice. And then I have my other bunch of blues because I totally love blue. Green would also be a good option, but since I want to use this, it's going to be lost, and I want this also to pop. So after checking on this together, seems like this would be a better color than this, because I am also going to add the blue in the shadow areas, which is just a little hint of crayon over here, water soluble, in the areas that go towards the bottom, which is what in this particular picture has some shadowing. So that's the one thing that is stopping me from getting the other type of blue. If you put too much with this type of crayon, is the fun part that you can always keep brushing and brushing until it is the right spot and the right amount of it. because sometimes you have a ton and sometimes you have very little, and you can just kind of brush it this way and the other. Well, let's reconsider. Probably now that I have the blue, the pink will be fine. But now I have this thing that they are, if you were to see this in black and white, these are still very close in value. So, I'm going to be back. I'm going to be thinking a little bit about it and make my final decision. Okay, when you cannot decide between pink and blue, get some purple. So I am going to be using this grape purple. It is Pacific Iris from Martha Stewart, but I think at this point any purple would be a good purple. Let's see what happens. I think I'm in the right direction, color-wise. So here we go. Because now my hand looks very kind of erased compared to this color, which ended up with more texture than I was planning, I'm going to add a little bit of white lines with this white marker. For now, I think I'm just going to add it in the outside where the highlights should be. And I think I'm going to add some marker, this pit pen. I think it'll be too strong, so I will go with a little bit of lines with my micron, which I know is very thin, but maybe this is the thing. I like it. For now, I think we are done with this page. It's cute, it's colorful. I hope it showed you how to draw a hand very easily. You can select another type of photography with your own hand in any position, shape, or holding something, whatever you want, and just follow the procedure, which is making your little boxes and draw them. Later on, you can add color, make a beautiful page. Or if you want to start from a canvas, that's a little different because of the texture, but you can always, you know, practice and practice until you have it the way you want it. Thank you so much for visiting. I hope you had fun, and remember to keep your paintbrush wet.